The results are in, the election is over, and in a surprise upset that no one expected, and yet we're all somehow okay with, the presidency of the United States goes to the Green Party. That's right, Baby Yoda has been elected the next president of the United States, and the next president of all of our hearts.
Hashtag not my Baby Yoda.
You're wrong, and literally everyone disagrees with you. Hello all, I'm Josh, this is Josh Build Stuff, and today we are talking about everyone's favorite, the child, it's Baby Yoda, now in LEGO form. This is the child set from LEGO Star Wars. It contains 1,073 pieces, is suitable for ages 10 plus, and I think it came out around October-November 2020. We probably shouldn't be surprised to see this set since we just got a non-baby Yoda figure in about this same form earlier this year, though I do not own that set, but I just could not pass up the opportunity to own this little guy. Also, this set costs $80. I don't think I mentioned that, and that sounds like a lot of money for a baby, but a real baby would cost a lot more than $80. Not if you bought a real baby. I don't think that's legal in most places, but I've had two babies in hospitals, and man, that cost a lot of money. More than $80 for sure. I guess I didn't have the babies. My wife helped with the babies, but you know what I mean. Baby Yoda, much cheaper than baby human. This set is obviously another opportunity for LEGO to capitalize on the popularity of this little character from The Mandalorian. And are you watching Mandalorian Season 2? At the time of making this video, only Episode 1 is out and Episode 2 comes out tomorrow, and I'm very excited about it and I am liking it a lot. And if you spoil anything to me in the comments or Twitter or anywhere, I will be very unhappy. But this is obviously a set targeted towards fans like myself who like to display LEGO sets. There are not necessarily any play features, but much like a couple of sets we've got recently, like the BB-8 set and the Porg set from last year, this set comes with just the figure plus a little display plaque here with a spot to display this adorable tiny LEGO Baby Yoda minifigure. This is only the second set as of this time of making this video that contains this tiny minifigure. The other set is the Razor Crest, which is a little more expensive than this set. This set is $80. The Razor Crest was like $120, $130. So this right now is the cheapest set where you can get this tiny Baby Yoda minifigure. So I will share with you some of my opinions on this little guy in a second. But first, let's talk about the build. So let's talk about the build. It was a lot of brown. It was like the first 6 bags out of 8 bags were all just a bunch of this brown color that went into building Baby Yoda's coat, which was unsurprising, but obviously got a little tedious after the 3rd or 4th side of Baby Yoda's body. As for the build itself, it is actually remarkably similar to the Porg, which was released, I don't know, last year or so, where you build a square cube Technic structure on the inside and then build the 4 sides of Baby Yoda one at a time, and then those sides get attached to that center structure. So for those wondering if Baby Yoda is hollow down the center, in this case, he is. The face and hands are where a lot of the detail comes out in this set, and so obviously that's where a lot of the little detail building really came into play. Overall, I think there were a lot of really interesting build techniques used in this set, and I think it comes together in the end really nicely. The first thing a lot of people might point out about this set is its size. Obviously, he's slightly undersized. He only measures about 8 inches tall right now, and a lot of people might be expecting a larger character like this, who currently measures about 12 inches tall. That's pretty big. If we had a LEGO set that was 12 inches tall, well, that would take a lot more pieces. But really, with this little 8 inch tall version, I don't know, 1,000 pieces, 8 inches tall, I think that's a good size, especially for me, where I have my shelves behind me, which are right about 13 inches each, and so that gives me a nice little clearance to display this figure, even though he is only 8 inches tall. And some people may say that's very small, but we have a very small figure. He's right here, and he only measures about, I don't know, 5/8 of an inch tall. I need a taller ceiling for this bit. But aside from this little dude's size, I think LEGO did a really nice job capturing his overall likeness. Obviously, LEGO wasn't going to be able to make a perfect 1-to-1 scale recreation of Baby Yoda as we see him in the show, but I think LEGO captured the most important part about Baby Yoda with this figure, and that is, he's cute. And I think Baby Yoda's cuteness right now is kind of his main appeal in the show, besides maybe the overall mystery that kind of surrounds him and the fact that he is right now driving the entire direction of the show. But besides that, his main draw and appeal and purpose right now is to be super cute and sell a bunch of merchandise. I think he's important for selling merchandise. And so I think LEGO did capture that most important aspect of him, because in this form, I still think he's very cute. Then again, maybe all LEGO had to do was make him cute, was give him these big old black beady eyes, make him look up slightly at the Mandalorian, open his little Baby Yoda mouth up just so much, and have him go, ah. Speaking of his expression, there is a little bit of articulation that goes into the face, and I guess in the hands too, but those can really barely move. You can kind of adjust the hand's position and the fingers a tiny bit, but those little fingers will kind of pop off if you do that, and you don't want to hurt Baby Yoda, so please be careful when handling him. But in the face, he has slightly more articulation. Obviously, you can't really change his expression, but you can tilt his head up and down slightly. You can move his head forward and backwards. His ears can be tilted up or down, which actually gives a good amount of expression to his face by just changing that one little detail. His mouth can also be opened and closed, which, again, surprisingly changes the expression and mood on this little dude's face a lot, even though you're only moving a few small pieces. Personally, it saddens me deeply to see Baby Yoda saddened, and so I like to keep his expression in a happier sense, where his head is tilted, his mouth is open, and his ears are up. Besides the head, the only other kind of interesting bit in this set worth talking about is probably his hands. Like I said, they're very slightly articulatable. But LEGO does include this small gray sphere, which in this case is meant to represent the shifter knob from the Razor Crest, which Baby Yoda enjoyed playing with in the first season of The Mandalorian, and I find it interesting that it's called a shifter knob, like you're up there in space shifting the Razor Crest, like double clutching like Vin Diesel in space. LEGO did include this little plaque bit that we've gotten in a couple of other sets that are like this one. Ones that come to mind are BB-8 and the Porg sets. Both of those got little display pieces like this with a little spot where you can stick a minifigure. Unsurprisingly, this plaque gives us significantly less information than we've gotten in some sets in the past, like his homeworld is unknown, as is his species, and all we really know about him is that he's 50 years old, and he hangs out with the Mandalorian, and he loves playing with the shifter knob. Obviously, when it comes to minifigures, there aren't a lot with this set, but there is one minifigure, and he may be the only minifigure that matters right now, and that's this teeny tiny Baby Yoda minifigure who, like I said, comes in only this set and in the Razor Crest set, and this set is a slightly cheaper way to acquire this little figure. What can I say about him? He's great, he's tiny, his eyes are even slightly more oversized than I think they would need to be for this little figure's size, and I think that makes him all the better. If you think there are any issues with this Baby Yoda minifigure, or that he could be improved in some way, then let me know in the comments below, because that will tell me who I need to block from my channel forever, because this little guy is perfect and your opinions are wrong. Just kidding, your opinions are valid, but wouldn't the world be a brighter place, and wouldn't everyone be just a little bit happier if we all just had a little more Baby Yoda minifigure in our lives? So my final thoughts on this set, it's pretty much what you see is what you get. It's not like most LEGO sets where you could buy it and experience it for yourself, play with it, see the ship, whatever, and be pleasantly surprised or somehow disappointed. It's a Baby Yoda figure, and you can see exactly what you're going to get. I think the only thing you might be surprised by is his size, and I think I've done a pretty thorough job of explaining that to you. If you are on the fence about this set, or are unsure about paying $80 for a LEGO Baby Yoda, maybe you can do what I did and buy it from Target, where all toys were 25% off, and even though that coupon excludes LEGO, the employee might still give you 25% off. And so this set ends up being a $60 set, which to me is a very good deal. However, if you are unable to get a deal like that one, $80 for this set may be a little steep for some, and I think only people who really, really like The Mandalorian and LEGO, like myself, would be willing to pay that price for this piece. But who knows, maybe there are some brick sellers out there who are looking for a very large quantity of this exact color of brown, or are trying to find a lot of this exact color of Baby Yoda green, as I call it. There are probably not a lot of other sets which contain such large quantities of these couple of colors. Except for maybe the larger Yoda figure, which came out earlier. But his eyes look weird, so this set may be a better buy in that regard. Plus, you get tiny, teeny, tiny Baby Yoda. Some brief channel business. This is your final chance to ask questions in the upcoming Q&A video that we are making because we hit 1,000 subscribers. So thank you to those 1,000 plus subscribers at this point. And thank you to those who have already asked questions. I am keeping track of all of those, so don't worry. Also, I think it would be fun to make that video a Q&A and giveaway video, mostly because I like the sound of that title, but also because I want to say thank you to all of you, and also because I have a whole bunch of Lego sitting around in boxes that I don't really have anything to do with, so maybe we'll give some of that back to you guys. As always, I do genuinely appreciate you all hanging out here, and I do hope you really enjoyed this video. And if you did, leave a comment below, or hit the like button, or tell your friends. All of those things really do help the channel grow. Again, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.
Why do you own so many tape measures?
I measure a lot of stuff. Also, I lose a lot of tape measures. And usually I'll lose a tape measure, and then I'll go out and buy a new tape measure to replace the one I lost. And of course, I will then find the one I lost, and then I will have more tape measures. But this isn't actually all the tape measures I even own. There are several that I own, which are currently lost, which I need to replace, and then I will find. And then I will have even more tape measures.